Hello friends, I welcome you to my YouTube channel MacPM. So in today's video we will solve a question which is based on the shear stress and bending stress both in a beam. So let's see the question. A simply supported wooden beam of span 1.3 meter. So we will draw the beam. This beam is simply supported, means at one end it is roller support, at one end it is hinge support. 1.3 meter is span, so it is 1.3 meter L, having a cross section of 150 mm wide and 250 mm deep. So the cross section of the beam is like this. It is a rectangular beam, so this is 150 mm and it is 250 mm. Carries a point load W at the center. So W is the load, point load at the center. So it is 1.3 by 2 is equal to 0.65 meter. And this is also 0.65 meter. The permissible shear stresses are 7 Newton per mm square in bending and 1 Newton per mm square in shearing. So it is given. Permissible stress in the bending means sigma is equal to 7 Newton per mm square, and tau is equal to shearing stress, which is 1 Newton per mm square. So we have these values. So we have to find shear load W. So for that, first of all, we have to find the maximum bending moment at this beam and maximum shear stress. Maximum bending stress and maximum shear stress at this beam. So let's find. First of all, we will draw the shear force diagram and bending moment diagram for this beam. See, so this is load W. So due to symmetry, because this is acting at the mid span, so this will be W by 2 and this will be W by 2. Reaction forces R1 and R2. But if you want to calculate, then you can calculate like this. Suppose this is R1. This is R2. Then we will take bending moment across this point. This is A, B, this is C. So moment about B is equal to 0. So R1 into this length is 1.3 is equal to W into this is 0.65. So R1 is W into 0.65 upon 1.3. so it is, this is 2, the W by 2. So R1 is W by 2, and we can see that summation of all the forces in vertical direction should be 0. So R1 plus R2 is equal to W. So R2 is W minus R1 is equal to W minus W by 2 is equal to W by 2. So we can see that R1 is W by 2 and R2 is equal to W by 2. Okay friends, so after this we will draw the shear force diagram of this beam. So from here we can see R2 is W by 2, so W by 2 we will draw here. Then there is no other force from B to C, so B to C it will be constant. Then W, so we will add W. Then it is constant up to here. Then this R1 will be W by 2 will become 0. So it is 0, 0 here. So we can see that maximum shear force at this beam is W by 2. Now similarly, if we want to draw the bending moment diagram of this beam, then bending moment will be W by 2 into 0.65 from here to here. So it will increase 0.65 into W by 2 into 0.65. so it will be like this. And after this bending moment, at A is equal to R2 into 1.3 minus W into 0.65. So it will be R2 is W by 2 into 1.3 minus W into 0.65. So if you calculate this, it will become 0. So we can see that bending moment at this point is 0, here it is 0. So it is increasing from here to here, and then it will become 0 again. So we can see that maximum bending moment is 0.375 W. Okay, so we have maximum shear force is equal to W by 2 or 0.5 W, and maximum bending moment is equal to 0.375 W. Now we have formula M upon I is equal to sigma upon Y. So for this one, the maximum bending moment at this beam cross section will be at the top fiber. So if you consider neutral axis here, then Y will be this distance. So it is Y is 250 by 2, is equal to 150 mm, and I will be BD cube by 12 for a rectangular section. So B is 150 into 250 cube divided by 12. So if you will calculate this, then you will get I is equal to 19531250 mm to the power 4. So this is I, this is Y, and sigma is already given, which is 7 newton per mm square. So we already have calculated maximum bending moment, which is 0.375 W. So we will put all the values in this formula. So we will get M is equal to 0.375 W divided by 19531250 is equal to sigma is 7 newton per mm square divided by Y is 250 by 2 is equal to 125. So it will be 125. So if you will calculate W from here, then you will get W is equal to 33653.8 newton. Sorry, there is another mistake. This is not 0.375, but it is 325, because we have calculated here 0.65 by 2 is 0.325. Sorry for the mistake. And one another thing, that bending moment we have calculated 0.325 W, where we have multiplied W with 0.65 meter, so it is in meter. So we will calculate convert it in mm. So 0.325 W will be 325 W newton per newton mm. So it will become 325 W, because we have converted meter into mm. So if you will put this value, W is equal to 7 into 19531250 divided by 125 into 325, then you will get this value. Sorry for the mistakes. I hope and you understand this part. So this is W for the bending moment. If we consider the shear stress condition, which is maximum shear stress is given as T is equal to tau is equal to 1 newton per mm square. Now it is a rectangular cross section, so shear stress will be shear force upon area. This is average shear stress, which is shear force upon area. So shear force is 0.5 W, and area will be 150 into 250. So this is average shear stress, and average shear stress will become If you will see our video on the shear stresses in the beam cross section, shear stress across the sections, then you will find that maximum shear stress at rectangular cross section is 1.5 times average shear stress. So maximum shear stress will become 1.5 into 0.5 W upon 150 into 250. So it will become 1 N/mm² as per given in the question, because you can see the maximum shear stress is given 1 N/mm². So this value will be equal to 1 N/mm². So you can get W from here. W is equal to 1 into 150 into 250 divided by 1.5 into 0.5. So you will get W is equal to 50,000 N. So you can see that as per the criteria of maximum shear stress, W is 50,000 N, and as per the bending stress criteria, it is 33,653 N. So we will choose the maximum W is equal to 33,653.8 N. Why? Because if you will consider this 50,000 N, then before reaching this shear stress limit, beam will fail because of the bending stress at this point. So we have to choose the minimum value. So this is the answer. I hope you understood. Thanks for watching this video.